like a dream. And now for a time you are mine. Let's hold fast to the dream that tastes and sparkles like wine. Who knows if it's real or just something we're both dreaming of? What seems like an interlude now could be the beginning of love. Loving you is a world that's strange, so much more than a heart can hold. Loving you makes my whole life change. Loving you, I could not grow old. No, nobody knows when love will end. So till then, sweet friend, time is like a dream. And now for a time you are mine. Let's hold fast to the dream and sparkles like wine. Who knows if it's real or just something we're both dreaming of? What seems like an interlude now could be the beginning.
You often pick up girls at parties. Because I'm not that sort. As you can see, I come from a respectable background.
You know, when I first saw you standing by the window, I could not believe it was you.
It is a fascinating country.
Oh, well, you. No, well, I'll tell you.
Excuse me. Good evening, maestro.
Stefan.
I'm glad you didn't have your hair cut short.
Sorry.
I said, I'm glad you didn't have your hair cut short.
I did. It's grown again. It
was all the same.
I've often wondered what it would be like meeting you again. I used to practice things I'd say to you.
You said nothing.
You sneaked up on me.
Oh, sorry.
How have you been, Stefan? I only know what I read in the papers.
Fine, fine, very well. All I know about you is what you write in the papers. What was here? Horses.
Cows.
Well, they must have looked like horses.
It's awful seeing it like this, isn't it? So?
Strange. Strange. You know, it occurred to me afterwards that lamp was dangerous. It could have caused a fire.
Do you know, I'd almost forgotten how strict you were.
Strict with you?
And bad-tempered.
Bad-tempered me. You must have dreamt this.
I want you to get over this chap Zelter, conductor. He's walked out, made a bit of a panic.
Quite a boy. He's always shouting at someone, so with a bit of luck, he made him shout at you.
Fancies himself a bit, doesn't he?
The release says he's walked out in the opera season because he's sick.
Sounds like a good reason.
It's an old reason. It doesn't add up.
Lend us a bit of paper, Mary.
Sure, go ahead.
You back already? Hello, yes. All right, thank you.
Hello, sir.
Hello, Jenny.
Hello, Sally.
Hello, love.
Have you got a minute?
No, I can't stop now. I'm just going out on a story.
Sally, I've got to talk to you. Sal, are you going out this evening?
I think so.
Do you think you can lend me the key to your flat, then? It's Carl.
He's
his wife's found out. Please, Sally, I promise you we'll be up by 11.
Oh, Natalie, I don't know why you get yourself so involved.
I won't ask you again, I promise. Thanks, Sal. I'll leave it in the usual place.
Now, we've got some stuff here on tonight's programme. Here we are. And here's, morning. Here's Stefan's biography, excuse the jargon. And there's a photograph of him. I don't think he's quite as young as he looks there.
That's where you start to track one. That's right.
Coming to two.
Around the back. And hold it steady there. Coming to two now.
49.
And start to zoom in.
Coming to three.
Very good, very good.
We're going to 121.
Now let's go to the end just to refresh our memory. 7 after H.
I don't do this sort of thing as a profession, gardener, but you get to know everyone who matters. Foot in the door, sort of.
Hold it there, one.
No, I'll tell you. Satire. That's my field.
Yes.
Mm. Short satirical sketches. The famine. They're crying out for them. If you can deliver, well, that's it. You're in. You print your own money. I'll fix it with Stefan. Give it to me.
72 on 3.
2. 1.
one. 84. 4. 84. 1. And zoom in 1.
85. Great. Splendid, gentlemen. I think we're in a very good way. I would suggest that we have lunch now. He told me that the canteen is now less crowded. I see you 4:30 with Tchaikovsky.
No, I didn't think it was quite the moment. Not to worry, I know just where we'll catch you.
It's going down.
What? Yes, it is. Very smart. Very smart. Morning. Ah, just as I thought. There he is. Mr. Can't understand it. Must be some sort of emergency. Not to panic. We'll catch him on the way back, as they say. come and have a bite in the canteen. Incidentally, do call me Bevis. Very smart, very smart.
Stefan Zelter, aged 41. That's a new one, they usually say 39. Went to the Vienna Academy of Music, studied under Swarovski. 2 years, New York Philharmonic, then London.
Hello, Daddy!
Now lives in Hertfordshire. Wife, 2 children, Sarah Jane, age 3, Simon 5.
Hello, my boy. Not too high, come here. Not too high, I promise, not too high.
Wife, Antonia, only child of Andrew Clark Field, merchant banker.
Hello.
Hello, darling. Lawrence is here for lunch.
Oh, good.
But I shouldn't have barged in like this. I don't think he'd be home.
How was the rehearsal, darling?
All right, improve. What's the matter with you, Lawrence?
Yeah, well, you might as well know. Everybody else does. Rosemary's left me.
When?
Last week. I waited. I thought she might come back, but she's divorcing me. I can't believe it. My own wife is divorcing me.
But why did she leave you?
Stefan.
No, it's all right. We're friends. You want to know why she left me? I'll tell you why she left me. She... Oh, various reasons, you know.
Of course, I'm afraid you've caught Stefan on a bad day. A lot of pressures. All makes him a bit edgier than usual. Not that I normally have any trouble with him at all. Perfectly straightforward. Have him literally eating out of my hand. Literally.
Literally.
Yes.
These are delicious. It's ambrosia, this. Oh, you're too beautiful, Antonia, to have any conception of the kind of problem I'm in. All you can deal with is a man who yells at orchestras. I mean, Rosemary was nice, but she was no orchestra, you know? You're fighting again, are you?
He's not really sick, you know.
Really?
I suppose I ought not to really tell you this, but he's just had a real old ding-dong with the management. That might make a good story.
You think so?
I do indeed. And what is more, I might be able to work him round to it for you. Another yogurt?
Really, Stefan?
What?
Asking why Rosemary left.
Maybe I have a practical motive. I must discover where the pitfalls are. If one wants to avoid them.
Good luck with the rehearsal, darling.
Thank you.
too.
Thing is, I'm really a writer. What I need is someone with ideas. Now, you work for a paper, new ideas every day. Your head must be bursting with them. So, what do you say? A few evenings a week. I do the writing.
Shut up!
You...
Right, the tape's coming to an end now.
Zoom out one and mix to one.
And three.
31 on one and three.
And take out three.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Zelter. Thank you, everybody. Would you just hold on for a moment for clearance from telerecording, please?
For the winds, we need a much bigger diminuendo on the end. Just let it die away.
Okay, studio. All clear now. Thank you very much.
Mr. Zelter? Yeah. Mr. Zelter, could you just spare us a moment? There's a young lady from the stand. I'd terribly appreciate a quick word.
I don't keep any interviews without any appointment.
Then could I make one?
Yes, we know that, Mr. Zelter, but she's been here all day. Just two or three minutes, we would be most grateful.
All right, I think my dressing room was only for 5 minutes.
Thank you very much indeed, Mr. Zelter. Thank you. Very nice of you. We are. Nothing to it.
I will not work with idiots.
Oh, so it's not true you were sick?
True, what do you journalists know about the truth? The day you start writing it, I start telling it. The man was a hypocrite, a liar, and a fool. I will not work with him. But of course you won't grant it, because lies are more comfortable and bring more money. But I don't like liars, and if this means I don't like journalists, so I don't like journalists. Miss...
Carter.
I suppose you are displeased with me.
I thought you were the one who was angry.
Who's angry? No, I'm merely surrounded by...
Liars?
No, idiots! And liars. You have a car?
No, I haven't.
You want a lift?
Thank you.
You've chosen a most dubious trade, Miss Carter.
Thank you very much. I'll see you tonight, then. On the telly. You can always reach me at the paper, just in case you want to see.
You do realize that for the time being you're totally unemployable. If you so much as lift a baton, they'll claim you broke your contract simply in order to do other things. And then we'll both be up to our tits in injunctions.
It's ridiculous.
Yes, yes, of course it's ridiculous. But I'm afraid your talking to that girl didn't really help us. Not that I blame you, of course. It's just a pity that the press got hold of the truth before we really made up our minds about what we were going to say.
I don't think we need to go into that.
No, no. Of course not. No permanent damage done. It will take a few days to sort out. I think a diplomatic rest is in order.
I'm not like you. I need to work.
You can start a hobby. Or spend some time with your nearest and dearest. Or with your wife and family, come to that.
There's a string missing.
But no work.
Well, I think I take Antonia to lunch.
That's the idea. Eat, drink, and be merry. For tomorrow, we litigate. Middle phone. Come along, Paris. That reporter. Was she pretty?
Young.
Same thing, dear.
Heel!
Sir. No, sir, the madame is out.
For you, Princess, because you've been so terribly good. Hello.
Hello, Lawrence. Stefan.
Oh, hi, Stefan. No, I'm working. I'm working on a terribly difficult piece at the moment, actually. Okay. Bye-bye.
Zelter, I'm going to lunch now.
Yes.
Is there anything I...
No, thank you. I go too, thank you. I was not discreet. It was a bad thing you did to me. You seduced me.
I what?
You seduced me to tell him the truth.
It didn't need much seducing.
And then you put it in your newspaper. It was unforgivable.
Yesterday I was a liar. Today I tell the truth, and that's even worse. I can't win.
You know, composers wrote for the finest instruments, not only for, no thank you, for violins and pianos, flutes. They wrote for wind machines and all kind of stuff, even for glasses, you know? Look.
Oh.
Now listen.
It'll never catch on. Concerto for wine glass and index finger. I don't think it'll make the top 20. Anyway, they didn't do it with just glasses.
But with glasses, with ordinary glasses. Mozart wrote an adagio and rondo for flute, oboe, and cello, and glass harmonica, so the instrument was called.
He must have been very happy.
Oh, yes, he was dying, as a matter of fact.
$12:45 at the Connaught. Fine. Till tomorrow, then. Love to John. Bye. Thank you, darling. Sorry I missed you at lunch. Anything special?
No, not really. I thought you might have liked to come out to lunch with me, since I wasn't working.
Oh, Stefan, what a shame. Such a marvelous day. I took the children on the river. What did you do?
I? There's no ice.
Oh. Mario? Ice. Did you lunch alone?
No. I was with the journalist who wrote the article yesterday.
You didn't tell him anything, I hope.
Tell him? No, I behaved very well.
Well, what about Mozart? He wrote Don Juan.
Don Juan doesn't exist anymore either in these days, because there's nothing to seduce anymore. They do it out of politeness, so they say. But I fear even when young, I was what you would call a square.
Oh, I wouldn't say so.
No?
No, more of a smoothie.
A what?
A smoothie. Which still doesn't answer my question. Is everyone in bed with everyone else?
Are you?
Not at this moment. Does your wife know we're having lunch?
More coffee, sir?
No, thank you. No.
Are you going to tell her?
No.
Tea?
Tea.
It always sticks. After you. I'll put the kettle on. Won't take a minute. Do sit down.
Thank you.
That's Rover.
Who?
Rover. It's all right, he won't bite. I say, you don't know anything about clocks, do you?
No. You're a great fan of mine.
What's that?
Oh, at least one.
It's ready.
May I help you?
Thank you. Just let it brew for a moment.
Of course.
Do you like your milk in first?
No, after.
Oops. Sorry. I forgot to put the tea in. I've never done that before.
No. Thank you. Yes, my marriage is a happy one, I think. I'm generally faithful to Antonia. I mean, rather faithful. No, she is important to me. As a human being. And also for my work. I admit my work is the most important thing in my life. I'm an egoist. All artists are, so they say. Sure, I've known other women. When you are alone in a foreign city and everything goes well and you are excited, or everything goes bad and you are depressed. And there's somebody there nice and sympathetic. It's very natural for a man to find women attractive. I do. Pardon me?
I don't want to see you again.
I see.
I'm sorry. It led in a mess. You'd much better go.
What are you looking for?
Nothing.
How was your lunch with Lawrence?
Dull.
Did he tell you why Rosemary left him?
No.
Didn't you ask?
No.
It's extraordinary. All our friends seem to be in some awful kind of marital mess. Divorcing, quarrelling, separating. Have you noticed, Stefan? Stefan? Is it our age? What is it? Presses me. Do you think Rosemary's left him for good? Or do you think she's just trying to teach him a
lesson? Antonia, please. Leave me alone.
See, are the woodwinds, the brass, and here the drums, but they're not in yet. And here the strings, the violins, viola, cello, and contrabass. And here comes the theme, bum 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 bim bim bim, picked up by the clarinets here, and the oboe and the flute. And this is how a score is built up. Who was after David?
Mm-hmm.
I ask you, who was after David?
Oh, after David, there were hundreds.
Really?
Well, one builds up a score.
Oh, I see.
Still too many.
Hmm?
Anyway, until you get married, the number doesn't count.
No?
No.
Do we plan to get married?
No, of course not. Oh. Hello? Oh, hello, John.
What?
Well, how are you? Oh, I've been busy.
Hmm?
Nothing special. A bit boring, really.
I've been improving my mind, and we all know how exciting that can be. Look, I've got to go. Yeah, call me. Bye. Stefan, I didn't mean it. I was joking.
I don't understand this kind of jokes.
I'm sorry, I'm stupid.
Who was it?
Only John.
Was he one of those who doesn't count?
Of course he doesn't count. He's one of those bad-tempered bastards who can't take a joke.
You see, one can move it up and down here. This my watchmaker he used to do. And would you mind to close the curtains, please? And would you get me some matches, please, too? Thank you. Thank you. I closed the this curtain here. And you light it. The flame should not be too high, otherwise the cylinder cracks. I know this from my grandmother. She had one, too. So, please give me the cylinder now. Not the other one. Oh. Thank you. The watchmaker used this, that light doesn't blind them when they are working. Warms the place, doesn't it?
Oh, I love the lamp, Stefan. And I love you.
Huh?
I mean, I think I love you.
I didn't hear you.
Grandmother, what great teeth you've got. All the better to eat you with, my dear. And as she said that,
Don't bite me again.
Why? But it's the wolf who bite you. And as she said, the wicked wolf jumped up in the bed to spring on little Red Riding Hood and gobbled her up.
A wolf. Woo, 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 woo. A wolf. Woo, 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 woo.
Dressed in Granny's nightcap and spectacles and just about to swallow little Red Riding Hood up.
Thank you. Oh, he's gone.
Go on, darling. Have your evening.
Good night.
You're leaving it rather late, aren't you?
What?
Well, isn't it this evening you're dining with Federico? Had you forgotten?
Well, yes, I've forgotten. It's the last thing I want to do tonight. I can't...
You must. You promised. Besides, you and he hardly ever see each other.
Well, I'm afraid it's too late to get out of it. You know how he talks. God knows what time I'll be home.
We have no apron string, eh, Stefan? No. We stay, let them go. They are children. They must go to their wife. Please, sit there right. For me.
Who is it?
It's me.
Hello, my love.
You can't be serious.
May I come in?
Was it so difficult to get away?
I was with a friend.
Then why tear yourself away?
May I come in or should I go?
Oh, how lovely.
It isn't as if we were going anywhere.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
We never do go anywhere. How convenient that I'm already undressed. It'll save you time.
Don't be vulgar.
Why not? I've just spent a lovely evening on my own, which is something I'm getting quite used to. And here I am, all ready for the celebration.
Yes, I admit I'm late. But there's no reason for such a scene.
You could have told him. If he is a friend of yours.
He's also a friend of my wife's.
Do you know what I feel like?
I think I do.
You can't. Nobody can.
It's me.
Mother and father want to come down next weekend instead of later. I could put them off. Stefan?
No, it's fine. Let them come.
Sure?
Oh, sure.
You know, with everyone here, I probably won't get a moment to myself. Darling, why didn't you go away for a few days? On your own. It'll do you good. It'll be your last chance before starting rehearsals again. You could go down to the coast. You know, sea air was always Nanny's recipe for everything.
Yes, I can give you the Elizabethan room for the 22nd for 3 nights. That's the four-poster with bar. Yes. You will write and confirm it, won't you? Thank you. Goodbye. I'm so sorry. May I help you?
Please, Mr. Drew, I have a reservation.
What name, sir?
Mr. and Mrs. Krauss.
Yes, room 15, Dr. Sims' bedchamber. Will you sign, please?
Thank you.
Fred!
Krauss. Well, at least it's better than Schmidt.
After you, sir, madam.
Thank you.
Your key, sir.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Expecting someone. Perhaps it's for the chaperone.
No, it's just in case we quarrel.
No, I'll unpack.
Can't have you telling your wife you're not being looked after.
No, I don't hang my shirts. I like them folded in a drawer.
I have to make a telephone call. I'll see you downstairs.
Oh, there's a phone here.
I promise I'd call home. Just to see that all is well. Just ringing home to see that all is well. Hello, Sally. May I invite you for dinner?
Remember, see page 99. honest mistress. By our first strange and fatal interview, by all desires which thereof did ensue, by our long starving hopes, by that remorse which my words, masculine persuasive force, begot in thee, and by the memory of hurts which spies and rivals threatened me.
I calmly beg. For touching me with life.
But you must have been in love with her.
Why must?
Otherwise, why marry?
Oh, yes.
And you?
Yes, I loved her too. Let's go.
Ready. I suppose you'll go home now.
I must.
I suppose you'll be wanting to see the children.
Yes.
And Antonia. No, I can manage.
I'll ring you tomorrow.
How are your parents, all right?
Yes, fine.
I'm sorry I was too late to see them.
Mother's gone to bed. Daddy's gone out with some of his old business friends. Says he's making up for life in the country. Stefan?
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad you're here. I've been waiting for you.
Is something wrong?
Yes. You haven't been here.
For 2 whole days?
Longer. Much longer.
There's Humphrey over there.
Who?
Humphrey. Why don't you walk along? I think you're late.
What?
Hello, Humphrey. How are you?
How's the world's worker?
All right, I guess.
Oh, I fixed it up with them pretty firmly. Yeah. I told them they shouldn't be so dog in the manger. If you want to work somewhere else, it's no spin off their
thoughts. Rather rush, I'm sorry.
First concert at the festival hall.
All right.
Give my love to Antonia.
Lies he used to tell. Unbelievable.
Doesn't anymore. Well, I mean, he knows he doesn't have to bother.
I mean, I'm not likely to leave him after 3 years, am I?
Well, you should.
But I love him.
Your body.
The amount of time you wait till he comes round. You spend a fortune buying new dresses, getting your hair done. Then the night he turns up, you usually start with the curse or something.
The risks they take in the beginning, when they're not sure of you. It's fantastic. You see them day and night. It's always the best the first week.
Once they've got you, it all changes. It's just part of the rules. You mustn't write to them. You mustn't phone them. It can be quite a strain on the nerves. Mine does that too.
It's awful the importance a phone can have in your life. You sit and wait for hours for them to ring. And usually it's the wrong number.
In the beginning, I used to phone him late at night, just to hear his voice. When he'd say the number, I used to hang up.
Want some more tea, Natalie?
I've been hearing things about you, Sally. At the office.
What things?
They say you're in the same state.
Who said that? I bet it was that Jenny. She's always listening.
It's funny to think of you being involved, though. I mean, you've always seemed so sure of yourself. Do you love him?
I don't know. I suppose I do. Yes, I suppose I do.
Anyway, at least yours takes you out.
Where did you go? I couldn't find you.
You can't come in. I've someone with me.
Oh.
A girl from the office. Look, I can't talk now. Ring me if you want to.
If I want to? What's the matter? Why did you go away?
Not now.
Yes, now. Why?
Because I felt sick.
Be reasonable. You know we can't be seen together.
Well, we have been.
Who's was?
I don't know. Someone from the office. I must go in. Call me.
But does Antonia know?
Of course not. The other day I said we had lunch together, so when you see her, don't make a mistake.
Look, Stefan, it is not worth it.
No, it's not like this.
Oh, come on, this is Daddy, you know. I graduated from that school with 2 degrees, decree nisi and decree absolute. Now, you are putting your marriage right on the line.
Can you scream a little bit louder that we have 2 more in the press?
Oh, I'm sorry, look. But you are. You're putting your marriage right on the line. Just because you want to get your feet wet with some silly little teeny bopper. Now, come on, Stefan. Oh, God. Stefan, I'll help you. I'll cover for you. You know me. I'm a tower of weakness.
How many for lunch? Won't be much, I'm afraid. Not with Simon's party this afternoon.
Andrew's going out. Aren't you? Aren't you?
Yes, I thought I might have lunch at the club. Look up a few of my cronies. If they haven't all died off by now.
Stefan.
I'm afraid I have to see Lawrence. Bye-bye now. Bye-bye.
Where are you going?
I have a meeting in town. I will be back.
Darling, will you be back in time?
Yes, I will be back in time.
Daddy?
Oh, I'll certainly be back for tea, as long as you don't expect me to make conversation with those nannies.
Thank you.
By soon enough. Hot in town today.
Yes, very.
Exhausting place, London. I'd almost forgotten. Shan't be sorry to get back to the country. Of course, I wouldn't dream of going before your concert. I'm looking forward to that.
Thank you.
Got something interesting for us?
Oh, yes, Dvorak Carnival and Brahms Third.
Oh, good. That girl I was with today, an old friend of mine. Well, not exactly a friend, and not very old either. I used to take a fatherly interest in her. She's had a bad time of it. Family trouble.
Oh, really?
So I thought I'd take her out to lunch and see how she's getting on. Just the same, I wouldn't mention this to Antonia's mother. Least said, soon as mended, as they say.
Look, Andrew, it's really none of my business.
After all, we're both men of the world. Where's the harm in a little fun if it doesn't hurt anyone? Eh? And not that I'd pry, but I dare say when you're on those concert tours, you've managed...
Excuse me, I have still a little work to do. I see you later.
It's good to have you back, Stefan.
Thank you.
And don't forget, no anthem tonight. No. Go straight on with the Dvorak.
All right.
Hals und Beinbruch.
Thank you. Now.
We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Marvellous, marvellous. Going absolutely beautifully.
Hello, Stefan.
Who is it? Hello.
Who was it?
I don't know. They hung up.
But you say I'm important to you.
You are.
I'm not part of your life. I've nothing to do with it.
You are part of my life. Do you know how my life is? My life is arranged. Rehearsal, concerts, appearances. I'm not free. For the next 2 years, every day of my life is arranged.
So I should really be grateful.
Patient.
Patience depends on what you're waiting for. Where are you going tonight?
I must go home.
Oh, that old place.
You know, you have no reason to be jealous of Antonia. You have no cause.
Who's jealous?
Aren't you?
No. She's just a name you mention. She's nothing to do with you and me. All right, she's your wife. But that's a word. And I sleep with you. When I can. Do you think I could do it if she was real to me? How can I be jealous of someone who isn't real? And she isn't. I won't let her be.
Good morning, Miss Chester.
How are you?
Oh, I'm fine, thank you.
Sally, will you help Mrs. Zelter? Madam has an 11:30 appointment with Aldo.
Good morning. Good morning, Sally. How was your holiday?
Marvellous.
Good. You're too hot in it, I'm afraid.
Yes. Are the children well, Mrs. Zelter?
Oh, yes, they're fine. Thank you.
Good morning, madame.
Morning,
how are
Aldo.
You?
Fine, thank you.
Good morning, Mrs. Zelter.
Hello, Mrs. Zelter.
Would you like to come and this way, madame?
Oh, thank you.
Shampoo and set today for you, madame?
Oh, shampoo and set. I think I'll have a rinse today.
I saw Antonia.
What?
A few hours ago, I saw her.
Where?
Does it matter where? At the hairdresser's.
You mean she knows who you are?
Oh, yes. I went up to her and said, how do you do? I'm your husband's mistress. I saw her, Stefan. I saw her and I heard her talking. She didn't know me. Nothing happened. I said she wasn't real. I should have said, touch wood. She's obviously not what I thought. I don't know why, but I'd pictured someone sort of cold and she's not much older than I am. I sat there and I watched her. And I thought how much we could hurt her. So I can't go on.
I see.
All of a sudden, she has a face and I can't go on.
I will talk to her.
In Moscow, I gave 3 concerts. In Prague, 2.
He was fantastic.
That's not my point. In both cities, 75% of my audience was under 25. Well, I think that speaks for itself.
Popular prices. What are you talking about?
Cheap seats. No, the point is that youth is beginning to reclaim what was stolen from it.
And what's that?
The world.
Oh, yes.
Look, science has helped men to live longer. They grow old, selfish and impotent. But they will not give up control of the world. They hang on. Music, painting, literature, they've all decayed because old men will not give way. Well, now it is changing. The young are taking over. In music, first it was the pop artists. Soon it will happen on the concert platform.
What do you expect us Methuselahs to do then? Drop dead?
No, just keep quiet. I believe that reproduction is the beginning of death.
Do you?
In medieval times, men were married at 15 or 16. At 30, they were middle-aged. They died, old men, at 40.
What?
Or is it? Have you ever seen a man past 40 pretending that for him it's still the springtime? A man no longer young who kisses a girl in the darkness of a cinema?
Yes. Well, it's rather sad.
But with respect, I don't think so. I find that it offends me. To me, it is against nature.
Whose nature? Yours? May I tell you what offends me?
Yes, if you like.
Oh, yes, I like. What offends me is to see the young people going to bed together simply because youth is their justification. They have no affection, sometimes no liking. For them, the biggest sin is to become involved. But love is involvement. So love doesn't offend me. And when you grow older, you see there's still a young man living in you who's able to love deeply and painful, and that he has the need for love. So when a real woman responds to it, he will accept it, being grateful, and will try to hold what was given to him. So I don't find love offensive.
Sorry, I couldn't talk to her. There was an incident. It wasn't possible. I will try tomorrow.
Keep it beautifully. Did someone come in?
The carpet fluffs terribly. The leather, though, is just a damp cloth and it's clean. I had a woman, but she kept messing up my scores.
I was just shopping. I thought I'd drop in.
And what a great and profound pleasure it is, madam. Would you care for a drink?
No, thank you. Lawrence, do you and Stefan see a lot of each other now?
Well, last night, actually, he was sitting at the head of the table. I was down about here.
No, I mean, do you see much of each other at the moment?
Well, we play billiards once in a while. No, you know, I mean, we bump into each other, yeah. And he calls me up sometimes and...
Is he seeing some woman?
Is he what?
I tried to ask him last night after you'd gone, but I couldn't. It was easier to come here. Not so honest, perhaps, but easier.
Oh, Antonia.
The least I can do is ask you outright.
Oh, yeah, you must feel free to.
Lawrence, if you knew, would you tell me?
Oh, if I knew, Antonia, I would tell Stefan straight to his face that I thought he was the biggest fool in the world.
Thank you, but would you tell me?
No. No, I guess probably not. Are you sure you wouldn't like a drink?
Quite sure.
I guess if it was true, that'd probably make you and me two of a kind, eh?
Yes, it might, if it were true.
Look, Antonia, I know it's ridiculous, but if there ever is any trouble, I'd want you to feel free to come and take from me whatever you want, you know, whatever you need, whatever I can give you.
No trouble, Lawrence. Thank you.
I didn't want you to... I didn't mean...
Bye.
to take over. I'd like to listen to the balance with the organ. Please, from 39.
I won't divorce you. Though I don't suppose that'll stop you living with her.
I didn't ask you for a divorce. I don't ask you for anything.
I saw you with her, but I didn't see her face.
I wanted to talk to you about it today.
Why did you say that?
Because it's true.
But why say it?
Darlings.
Who told you?
No one.
You mean just seeing me with her?
No. You seem to be different. First, I thought it was you're not working. Then there was that call. Was that her?
Yes.
Oh, can't they? It's so hot.
Didn't tell you that story Colin told me, did I? About the man he works with in his office. He's having an affair with this girl on the side, you see, and he spends most nights with her. Well, one night is at home with his wife, and about 4 o'clock in the morning, he creeps up and starts putting his clothes on ever so quietly, and his wife wakes up and looks at him and says, where are you going? And he turns around and looks at her and says, oh, Christ, I'm here already.
But you think I should go, Natalie? I was so surprised when she rang. I said yes, but I don't know.
Well, of course you should. I mean, you said you'd go. Well, if you don't, she'll be your actual Joan of Arc, the full martyr. He'll be there, won't he?
Oh, yes, I wouldn't go on my own.
Well, then, be in a restaurant, won't be a slanging match. She'll be there, the mother of his kids. No, I mean, she'll be ever so ladylike, try to freeze you out.
What do you think she wants?
Well, to split you up, make you feel as guilty as possible.
Well, at least she knows now.
Yes, I suppose that's something. Still, I mean, even if they break up and you get married and everything. I'm not saying you won't be happy, but I mean, she'll keep the children. He'll have to see them. I mean, you never really break them up altogether. Not when they've been married that long. At least, that's what I think.
You're supposed to be on my side.
Oh, I'm sorry, love. Anyway, you've got to go. I'd wear something new if I was you.
Yeah. I think I'll wear white.
Sally, that Mrs. Antonia. Madame.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Sir. Would you like a drink? I don't know if it was such a good idea to meet in a restaurant.
I'm afraid that was my fault.
Can you have a few minutes?
No, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
They do fuss.
Thank you.
Yes. The reason I...
Yes, thank you. I'll take my time.
I wish they'd stop.
Perhaps we better leave.
No. No, it doesn't matter. I'm afraid you may think I wasted your evening. Before Stefan and I were married, on the evenings we went out together, I used to sit in my bedroom afterwards and think of all the things I was going to say to him next time we met. Word for word. Everything that seemed romantic and true at the time. Of course, I never said any of it. One never does. Last night, I did the same thing. I was going to tell you how much looking after he needs. All sorts of nonsense. I thought it might make you think twice. Of course, it would do no such thing. I can see that now. So I've brought you here on a fool's errand. Nothing to say. fond of music. You love it.
I like it, of course.
If you want a divorce, I'll give you one. We must talk about the children, of course. But not this evening. I must go now. I'm sorry. Excuse me. No. No, stay. May I have the car?
Of course. Excuse me for a moment.
Please don't see me out, Stefan.
Getting light.
I can't remember half of what we've said. More coffee?
No, thank you.
Drink?
Mm-mm.
I remember what Antonia said. She was very sweet, except that thing about did I like music.
Did you love music?
I never thought it would come to this. Of all the things I imagined, I never imagined this. I imagined parting. I imagined that all right. I used to tell myself one day you'd let me down.
Did you ever think you could let me down?
I love you. You've given up everything for me, haven't you?
I never said anything like that.
Don't you feel it, though, somewhere?
You don't want to marry me.
I want to marry you. I just don't want to be your wife. It's not just Antonia or the children. I'm in love with you, and I won't have it become real and spoiled.
You're a child.
I'm sorry, Stefan. I just can't settle for less than we've had. I'm frightened, Stefan, that's all.
What are you afraid of?
I'm afraid that instead of being what you want, I'll be what you've got. Why should I share your life when I used to have one of my own?
Yes, why should you?
Stefan, don't.
You always imagined us parting because you wanted us to part.
What you really are doesn't need me. It doesn't need anyone.
But I love you.
I want you to go now. I'm terribly tired.
Yes. For you.
It's not over.
That's the trouble, isn't it? Please.
Goodbye. Why are you moving?
Lease expired.
You know, there are still quite often mornings when I wake up and I expect to see you.
I have the lamp in my house now.
And the marriage, is it good?
Yes, it's good.
Forgive me, I have a meeting with the orchestra to discuss the program for our next tour.
I understand. Sorry, I bumped into someone I used to know. I'm at the flat. I've just been clearing up a few things. I'll be home soon. My love, you'll be there, won't you? No, it's nothing really. I'll tell you when I see you.